Do you know that the human eye is comparable to a camera? With a resolution of close to 576 megapixel, it is better than the best of the cameras that we know as of now. Hi, I'm Dr. Sahana Jeevi, Medical Director of Parvati Nethralaya, and I often happens in my clinical practice that patients with retinal problems fail to understand what part of the eye it is because it's not seen. Or they say, doctor, I've just changed my glasses, or I've had a cataract surgery and I'm using these drops, and yet you're telling that there's a problem with the retina, and they don't know that these things are separate. So today in this video, I'm going to show you different parts of the camera and the structures that are related in the eye so that you have a better understanding of how the eye functions. First of all, the lens cap. This is the lens cap. It is comparable to our eyelids because, yes, unless you take the cap off, you cannot see. The next is the lens of the camera. I'm just going to take this off for better understanding. The lens has an outer clear area here, and then a series of lenses again which help in the focusing of the object. So similarly in the eye, we have the cornea, the outer transparent layer, and inside we have a transparent convex lens, which is the lens of the eye. This is the part which is affected by cataract. So the cornea and the lens together, they focus the image, the light that's coming from the image, onto the back part of the eye. In the camera, we have the aperture system, which controls the amount of light that comes, and that is comparable to the iris and the pupil. The iris is the part of the eye which gives you the eye color, brown, gray, blue, whatever, and it contracts and relaxes to increase or decrease the size of the pupil and thereby monitor the amount of light that's entering the eye. The camera inside has multiple parts. The main one being the image sensor. Image sensor is housed in the body of the camera and it's not seen from outside. It basically converts the optical signals into electronic signals that can be stored onto the memory card. Similarly, the light that falls onto the eye, falls on the cornea, passes through the pupil, gets diffracted by the lens, then falls on the retina. Once it falls on the retina converts these optical signals into neural signals, and these signals are passed to the brain through the optic nerve and a series of neural pathways. This is the optic nerve. So, like we cannot see the image sensor in a camera, we cannot see the retina and the optic nerve from the outside. However, if the lens and the whole system is normal and your image sensor is not working, that would also mean that irrespective of what you're doing, the image will not be captured in the camera. Similarly, even if your cornea and your lens is clear and you're wearing the adequate glasses, if the retina has a problem, which most often happens with problems like diabetes, hypertension, and a multitude of other infections, you would not be able to see properly. The optic nerve, the neural pathways, and the brain would be something comparable to your memory card and your LCD screen, which allows you to see the image. So this is pretty much the similarities between the eye and the camera. I hope this video was useful to you. Please leave your feedback, suggestions, and comments and queries in the comment section below. Thank you.